Thanks for the introduction, Austin. Hey everyone, my name is Zaeem Billah. I'm the current PGY4 integrated VIR resident here at KPLAMC, also known as KP Visla. And today I'll be talking to you about tips for a surgical intern year. I did a categorical surgical intern year here as part of the KP Visla program, but when I was a fourth year medical student, I was a strong believer that we all need to do surgical intern years to, you know, build a strong foundation for our VIR career. And I only applied to surgery intern years, and I, you know, that's my opinion. You'll hear a lot of opinions on this, but let me tell you why I think that you should do a surgical intern year and how to succeed during that year. All right, so these are just kind of the goals for any intern year, whether you do surgery, medicine, or a transitional year. I think that these are your four main goals of that year. One is to build on that foundation of medical knowledge that you've built throughout your clinical years of medical school. You've been working hard during those M2, M3, M4 years to build that clinical foundation. You've been rotating through multiple different disciplines at multiple different hospitals, and you've been building just a clinical fund of knowledge. And your goal during intern year is to just build upon that and build a strong foundation, because intern year is the first year of you being a full-fledged doctor, and it's gonna set the tone for the rest of your career. So you wanna build a strong foundation. Second is functioning as part of a medical team. You know, you got an entry-level knowledge into this as a medical student working as part of a team, but now you have that degree under your name, you're responsible for patient care, you're coordinating with ancillary staff, you're gonna have seniors and attendings to report to, you're gonna have medical students working under you, and it's important to learn how to function as part of that team. Managing a patient from admission to discharge, right? So this is a fundamental skill of an intern that you need to master by the end of the year. Once a patient gets admitted to your service, every part of their care is coordinated by you. Whether they eat that day, what medications are they gonna get? How much activity can they do? Can they get out of bed? All of that stuff is determined by the orders that you put in. And so having that responsibility, you know, it's nerve-wracking, but it's very important. And once you get very good at it and you're able to tuck your patients in, you're able to treat them like your family and make sure they're taken care of, it's really fun to, you know, have that responsibility and see patients succeed under your care. And lastly, being an effective communicator, right? As an intern, you're really the face of your medical team. You're the one that's communicating with the patient. Oftentimes, the intern is the one that spends the most time with the patient from the medical team. You're coordinating with other services and you're updating your seniors and your attendings throughout the day. So it's important to be an effective and efficient communicator. Now, why surgery, right? You know, you're gonna hear a lot of opinions. People are gonna say, why are you putting yourself through that? There is easier ways to spend your intern year. Why not just do a cush year where, you know, you're chilling out for a year and then start working hard PGY2? You're gonna hear that. And I know because I heard that when I was applying, but it's important to understand that your intern year is the foundation for the rest of your career. You know, it's so important to set the tone for the rest of your career. And if you spend that time during your first year in a cush year where you're not working as hard, you're just gonna start off PGY2 behind and you're gonna be struggling to catch up and you're gonna regret it. And so, you know, as someone who went through that year, I'm so thankful that I went through a surgery intern year. I had a lot of fun, you know, specific to VIR, why is surgery important? Because we're pretty much a surgical subspecialty. If you look at our workflow, our day-to-day, and you know how we operate, it's very similar to surgery. You need to be very efficient. You need to be balancing, taking care of patients on the floor, getting notes, orders, and making sure your patients are taken care of and getting scrubbed into the first case that day. So you need to be very efficient in order to do that. And being a surgery intern will get you that efficiency. Triage, what needs to be done right now? What can wait a few minutes? What can wait a few hours? What can be done tomorrow? You need to be constantly triaging all the different tasks that you need to be taking care of as a VIR, and you learn those skills as a surgery intern. Preoperative and perioperative management, right? How do you make sure that a patient is safe to undergo surgery, their NPO, their consent is done, they have everything they need to go to the OR, and how are you gonna manage them while they're in the OR, while they're in the angio suite, and postoperatively for immediate postoperative complications? How are you gonna take care of them long-term after they get out of the hospital? These are all skills that you need to develop during your foundational year. Next is anatomy and pathophysiology, right? Surgeons are master anatomists. They know where they are in the body based on relationships. And if you're learning anatomy from surgeons, that'll only help you during your diagnostic and interventional years, because as a radiologist, as a diagnostician, you need to know the anatomy in a 3D manner, coronal, sagittal, axial planes. And if you learn relationships, that'll make your life so much easier when you're on to your diagnostic and interventional years. Learning the pathophys, we treat a lot of the same patients that, you know, surgeons do. And so learning a lot of that pathophysiology and learning the natural history of disease is gonna go a long way. And lastly, surgical techniques and manual dexterity. The only way to get good at surgery is by practicing. You can't learn it, you can't read it in a textbook. So you need to practice your hand skills. And one of the things about vascular and interventional radiology is that you're really doing such delicate work. You're using the smallest muscles in your hands, and you need to practice those hand skills early on. And the only way to do that is by being in the OR and practicing and learning from mentors. So what to look for in a surgery program, right? There's so many surgery prelims out there and it's hard to pick. So, you know, some things that I looked for when I was interviewing, you know, the main thing was culture. That's something that you suss out during your interview day. Look at how the residents interact with each other and with attendings. And anytime you're interviewing, just ask yourself, do you see yourself being part of that culture, part of that program? Do people seem happy and respected? That's like the most important thing to look for in a surgical program. OR time, you wanna be in an OR. You don't want to be at a program where interns aren't operating, where, you know, the prelim surgical interns aren't operating, but the categorical surgery interns are. You need to get reps. And so you wanna suss out whether the prelim interns are in the OR. You wanna get clinic time. Clinic is where decisions are made and where the real learning happens, right? You wanna be able to work up patients, see how they ended up in your clinic, and make a decision on what's the best way to manage this patient. The only way to do that is by practicing and learning from the attendings. Try to get an ICU rotation during your intern year. ICU is the sickest of the sickest patients. And as vascular interventionalists, those are the patients that we are often treating. We're often treating patients in extremis. And if you get comfortable with, you know, ventilator settings, pressors, hemodynamics, all that stuff, during your foundational year, you get those concepts during your PGY1 year, you're only gonna be able to build upon those the next time you do ICU. Get exposure to attendings. You don't want, you know, 2-3 levels of residents between you and the attending. You wanna get some one-on-one time with the content expert on your team. And so you wanna be able to pick the brain of your attending and get some of their wisdom and knowledge. You want diverse subspecialty exposure. You want to be exposed to different subspecialties within general surgery, like surgonc, thoracic, cardiothoracic, vascular, colorectal, acute care, peds, surg, endocrine. We're treating a lot of those patients as clinical VIRs. And so when you get exposed to the surgical side of things, you can take that knowledge base and apply it to your future career as a VIR, because you'll have a better global understanding of the picture. Lastly, consider matching at the same place you do your VIR residency. You know, as part of the categorical program here, I developed very, very strong relationships with our surgeons. And so it goes a long way, because during the rest of the 6 years of my training, I can just build upon those relationships. You know, I built very strong relationships with our vascular surgeons. And, you know, sometimes we do cases with vascular surgery and they'll just trust me with their patient care because they know me and how I was as an intern. So it's important. It's an important thing to consider, but not a must. So tips for success, how are you gonna be a good surgery resident? You know, part of it is just being a good person, being nice to everyone, helping out, understanding that medicine is a team effort. You know, there's gonna be times where you're free and your co-residents are drowning in work, or you're drowning in work and your co-residents are free. And it's important to, you know, help out the team and contribute to a positive culture where people can just rely on each other to help get stuff done and take good care of patients. Being reliable and punctual, right? It sounds simple, but it goes a long way. Just being on time, being trustworthy. If your senior tells you to do something and they don't have to think about it twice, they just know it's gonna get done, that goes a long way. Efficiency and organization, right? When I first started as an intern, the first thing I did was get a bunch of dot phrases, order sets, all that stuff to make sure that I could get stuff done in the least amount of clicks possible and take the least amount of time to get some of those mundane tasks done so I can focus on patient care. Develop a systematic approach, do things the same way every time, getting in notes, orders, replenishing lights, whatever it is, do it the same way every single time, and that'll lead to less silly mistakes. writing things down. You know, when I was an intern, when I first started, I made the critical mistake of thinking that I would just remember what people told me and, you know, get things done. But I quickly realized that there's so much going on that you're going to miss small things. And the way to get around that is just writing things down so that you don't need to rely on your memory. You have it there as a task for you to get done. So just write things down. Being an effective communicator, you know, when you first start out, it's going to be hard to communicate with patients and other services because you're just not speaking the language as well. But it's a bunch of practice, you know, practice how you phrase things to patients or other teams. Ask a lot of questions. If someone tells you something and you don't quite understand it, make sure you clarify it. Don't just make assumptions. Preparation, right? You guys have prepared so much to get to where you are today, and residency is no different, right? You guys have been preparing for exams. You guys have been preparing for interviews, all that stuff. And so preparation is key to success, as always. You know, if you have clinic, read up on your patients before clinic. How did they get into the clinic? If you're operating that day, look up the steps. What are the indications or contraindications? Why is that patient on that table? Just, you know, prepare. Have supplies readily available. When I was an intern, I would always rummage through the supply closet before rounds. If there is dressing changes, wound back changes, any of that stuff, just have the supplies readily available. That goes a long way. Be curious. Curiosity is how you're really going to learn. Always ask why. Why are we using this suture? Why are we using this tool? Why is this patient on this surgery table? How did we come up with this decision to do surgery on this patient? That's going to go a long way. Be humble and teachable, right? Take feedback constructively. If someone's taking the time to give you feedback, you need to understand that they're taking the time out to make you improve as a person. The easy way out is just to not correct your mistakes and move on, right? But if someone's taking the time to give you constructive feedback, just take it well, you know, don't take it as a personal attack. Be teachable and people will want to teach you. And then lastly, I think a general approach to the year, just approach the year as if you're a categorical surgery resident. If you say, I'm going to be a surgery resident this year, the VIR training can wait. I just want to immerse myself in the surgical culture for this year. You'll do great. Last but not least, wellness is important, right? Everyone here knows that intern year is hard. It's a huge transition and mental health is important. You're not going to be able to take good care of patients. You're not going to learn if you're not in a good headspace, if you're burnt out. So it's important to get wellness. You know, I was lucky enough to be at a program where there was a great culture, where we hung out outside of the hospital. I had a bunch of prelims going into VIR. We're still, you know, great friends to this day. We're taking trips together, but, you know, it's important to take time for yourself, be well. On days off, schedule something fun to look forward to. It's easy on your, you know, one day off a week to just catch up on sleep and catch up on errands, but you need to do stuff that you're excited about as well. Keep in contact with the support system that's gotten you to where you are today, your family, your friends. It's easy to say, oh, I've been so busy, I haven't had time to talk, but make sure you make time to talk to the people you care about and do the things that you care about. You know, maintain your hobbies, gym, meditation, whatever makes you happy, do that stuff. Don't just be so tired that you don't, you know, take the time to do stuff that makes you happy. And just some final thoughts, you know, again, I can't say this enough. Intern year is the foundation of your career. It's so easy to just want to go to a cush program where you're working like 9 to 5, you're not working that hard, low call responsibilities, but you need to understand that you're going to be paying the price for that later on. You want to be busy. You want to build a strong foundation for the rest of your career. You don't want to start PGY2 and be behind. You want to start PGY2 and be ready to keep running. You want to be in a sprint once you get to that PGY2 year. And it goes a long way, right? If you're busy PGY1 year and your PGY2 is a little bit less chill, you're just going to be, you know, ready to go. And your attendings and your mentors at your VIR program are just going to appreciate how hard you work. And lastly, have fun, right? We're all here as part of a medical team. We're passionate about patient care. Have a lot of fun. Surgery year is a lot of fun. It's fun to operate on patients and see them do well postoperatively. You know, it's a very fun year. And, you know, it's important to remember why you're in medicine. You know, sometimes when you're really busy, it's hard to remember that. But, you know, just have fun with the year. Thank you for your time. And feel free to reach out to me at any point. I'll put my contact info in the chat. And thanks to all of you for coming out on Super Bowl Sunday and learning more about VIR and getting excited about it.